to the prohibition of events and gatherings. We had a discussion in the second stage in relation to public houses. Now, you issued a verbal directive at the weekend that pubs should close, and there's an issue in my constituency and in some other parts of the country where some pubs have continued to trade, which is shocking and alarming, and local communities are outraged by it. So I think you've engaged also with the vintners in relation to this. Will you be, subsequent to the passing of this legislation, be issuing a directive, a written directive or a ministerial order, ensuring that all pubs do in fact close? We know that 99% of them have, but others are gone rogue on us, unfortunately. So can you clarify that? Because it's important, obviously, from the public health perspective, but it's also important for the publicans who have closed, who are businesses and who are employers and who hope to reopen at some point in the future and to re-engage the staff that unfortunately many of them had to lay off, because they now have an issue with their insurance companies who are trying to step away from their liability, and they're getting into a standoff situation with the policy holders. They're saying that this was a verbal directive, that it's not non-binding, and I think that the trade needs, the pub trade needs a written directive or a written order from yourself or from the government. So can you confirm for us that you will do this after the passage of this legislation, or will you do it in any event anyway?
Look, in relation to the issue of the vintners, vintners associations behaved extremely responsibly. They came into government buildings on Sunday evening. They said to the chief medical officer and senior government officials that they were not in a position to comply with the social distancing. Therefore, there is an obligation, if you can't comply with the social distancing, to do the responsible thing and to close their businesses for a temporary period of time. The severity of that is not lost on me. That meant 7,000 pubs and 50,000 people temporarily lost their jobs. But they're doing it for the public good. And I certainly hope that when this country bounces back and we will get through this, that people will support responsible businesses who do this. This House is hopefully going to give the authority to me and my department to shut down events and places if they do not comply. And that's certainly a power that we may have after this legislation passes. In relation to rest for this, but the position is clear. If you're in a business, or if you're anywhere else, if you can't socially distance like we're doing in here, you shouldn't remain open without being able to do so. So today we've put on the Department of Health's website some very helpful guides to how you can socially distance, things you can put on your floor and mark out in your workplace. We'll also be asking the Health and Safety Authority and Environmental Health Officers to try and assist business. We all want to try and keep businesses open and keep our country open, but we want to do so in a way that isn't the public good, safe for workers and safe for everybody in society.